Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, as we are drawing closer to the auspicious month of Ramadan, it's important to note that the Ramadan of this year will be different from the previous years. The entire dynamics around the month of Ramadan will change. The spiritual atmosphere will be different. In the previous years, we were able to attend Taraweeh prayers at our local masajid, and we were also privileged to listen to the melodious recitation of the Holy Quran by our local imams. Unfortunately, the Taraweeh prayers in this year will have to be conducted remotely. On the same note, allow me to pause for a moment and address all those individuals that used to trivialize our imams, disrespect and underestimate our imams, that now time has come where you have to honor and dignify your imams. Time has come where you have to value your imams, because you're going to miss them. You're going to miss all the good effort carried out by your imams in the holy month of Ramadan. Moving on, not only will the spiritual atmosphere be different, but the social and traditional settings will also change. You will testify that many of us became so habitual in participating into the iftar programs at our local masajid, and sometimes even in the community centers. But in this year, we are not going to see any of these iftar programs. We're not going to see any of these. And while speaking about the iftar programs, I am not personally against hosting iftar programs. But I have a concern when I start seeing the level of extravagance in these iftar programs. When we spend thousands and thousands of dollars in feeding people who are self-sufficient, people who are financial capable, you spend thousands and thousands of dollars on people who have enough food stored at their homes, and forget the thousands, if not million, Muslims across the globe who live in the midst of poverty. Why that money cannot be spent on them? In this Ramadan, let's reach out to the poor Muslims who struggle to find the minimum to open their fasting with. And speaking about an important issue, while many of us are going to be lamenting and mourning over the suspension of the Taraweeh prayers, let's remember that the Sahaba Ridwanullahi alayhim ajma'in, the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, were confronted with a similar situation, if not greater. Our mother Aisha radiallahu anha narrates the incident in Al-Bukhari that when the Taraweeh prayers were first initiated by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he was accompanied and joined by a handful of Sahaba in the first night. The next day came, the news broke out in Medina that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam had initiated Taraweeh prayers. So in the second night, many Sahaba turned up. The third night came, the entire Masjid Nabawi was crowded by people. Subhanallah. Came the fourth night, something unusual happens. Sahaba turned up in the big number, but the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam did not come to lead them in prayers. Sahaba waited so patiently from Isha up till Fajr, waiting for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and at Fajr prayer, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam makes his way. He advances towards the Sahaba. He leads them in prayers, not in Taraweeh prayers, but in Fajr prayers. When the Fajr prayer was terminated, the Prophet ﷺ addressed his companions and said that, "Oh my companions, do not think that I was unaware of your presence in the masjid. I knew that you were waiting for me, but I have done this on purpose. I want to tell you that the Taraweeh prayers has now been suspended and cancelled." Can you imagine the level of anxiety and shock amongst the Sahaba? Subhanallah. But look, Sahaba did not become despondent. And further, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam told them that I have cancelled the Taraweeh prayers as a gesture of mercy for my ummah. Because if I continue leading you, my Sahaba, in Taraweeh prayers, I am afraid that this will be imposed on you. The Taraweeh prayers will become farad and become mandatory on the ummah, and hence it will be a burden over my ummah. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam did not want his ummah to be overburdened. Listen to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about the mercy of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam towards this ummah. The end of Surah Tawbah.
لقد جاءكم رسول من أنفسكم عزيز عليه ما عنتم حريص عليكم بالمؤمنين رؤوف رحيم.
Allah says that they have come to you. They have come to you a messenger from amongst yourself, meaning a messenger from within human race.
لقد جاءكم رسول من أنفسكم عزيز عليه ما عنتم.
It grieves him to see you be overburdened. It grieves the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to see his ummah going through difficulties, challenges, inconveniences, and being overburdened.
حريص عليكم.
He is concerned over you. بالمؤمنين رؤوف الرحيم صلى الله عليه وسلم. And this messenger, he is compassionate and merciful towards his followers. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reunite us with our messenger in al-Firdaus al-A'la. Ameen. Going back to our topic, the Sahaba did not become despondent because the Taraweeh prayers were cancelled. They knew that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, just like how Allah could be worshipped in the masajid, Allah could also be worshipped elsewhere. So they went and initiated their own Taraweehs in their own houses. And this is what we need to do. How? This is a big question. In the next episode, inshallah, we'll share with you some strategies, effective strategies, that can be used in your homes in order to achieve maximum in this Ramadan, inshallah. Please stay tuned until next time. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.